every year on the 11th of November, we commemorate those brave men who fought in the Great War of 1914 to 1918 and all those men and women who lost their lives in every conflict since. Soldiers today put themselves in danger on a daily basis on stress protection, professionalism and duty. It is important to remember today that those soldiers who fought in World War I were mostly citizens. Ordinary men who were taken from every profession and walk of life and thrown into an area of conflict, terror, fear and turmoil. Today, like every year, we want to show them gratitude and the respect they fully deserve. We want to ensure that 100 years later, their memory is forever remembered. Our school had the privilege of going on a trip to France and Belgium in September of this year to visit World War I battlefields. During their visit, numerous pupils were given the opportunity to visit the graves of some of their relatives who so freely give their lives for us. In this assembly, some of my fellow pupils will give us an insight into their experiences on the trip and tell us their own personal family stories. Can you tell us the name of your relative that fought in World War I?
The name of my relative was Thomas Robert Corcoran. The story of Thomas was that he was killed in action at the Battle of Messines.
And to remember him, what did you do in Belgium?
To remember Thomas, I was allowed to go and visit his grave and lay a plaque at it.
What was the name of your relative that fought in World War I?
He was called Alexander Wetherill. So he fought in Flanders and a bit of the shell came off when it exploded and hit him in the back of the head and he died a few hours later.
What did you do to remember him in Belgium?
When I went to Belgium, we were able to find his headstone and I left a stone in honour of the family.
What was the name of your relative?
The name of my relative was Billy McFadden. Well, he was in the trenches and there was a box of grenades and two of the pins had fallen out. So he jumped on the box of grenades knowing that he would die but saving lots of his friends.
In France, what did you do to remember him?
I went to the Ulster Tower and I laid a cross beside his memorial.
Our first afternoon on the trip was spent visiting numerous cemeteries for the soldiers that had died in World War I. When we arrived at Poelcapelle Cemetery, I immediately noticed row upon row of perfectly white tombstones. Our tour guide explained that whilst most of these were the final resting place for many men, there were a few tombstones without a name, as these particular soldiers could not be identified. Upon our arrival, we saw two tombstones that had the flag of the Ulster placed at them, and we did a poppy cross on behalf of everyone at Lurgan Junior High. The tour guide also had each of us choose a tombstone to stand beside and explained that this might be the very first time someone has ever visited this particular soldier's grave and that some of these men in front of us were as young as our year 10 male pupils. Our journey took us to the Beaumont Hamel as we stood in the remains of 100-year-old trenches. Our tour guide explained that the soldiers from Canada advanced over the top of these very trenches 100 years ago. And within 15 minutes of going over the top, 670 out of 780 were killed. 55,000 soldiers in total would lose their lives on the very ground that we were standing on in the first few days of the Battle of the Somme. The British had managed to dig underneath the German front line trenches and had planted 19 mines. On July the 1st, 1916, they detonated the explosives, resulting in 6,000 German casualties and this 100 metre deep crater. Finally, we arrived, travelled to the Ulster Tower and the Thiepval Memorial. Whilst we were able to visibly see the final standing place of many soldiers over the 3 days, many lost their lives and were never found. The Thiepval Memorial has the names of over 55,000 soldiers who were never able to come home and were lost forever.
The last post ceremony at Menin Gate in Belgium aims to express the debt we all owe to the men who fought and died in Europe between the years 1914 and 1918. During the last post ceremony, we no longer remember just those British soldiers that died, but also soldiers from Belgium, France, and many of our allied nations who willingly made the ultimate sacrifice for peace. We also remember that many died on the other side of no man's land, soldiers who were enemies then, but partners now in a united Europe. In this sense, the last post ceremony not only reflects Europe's troubled past, but is also a beacon of hope for our future. Every day, just before 8 in the evening, the local police halt traffic passing through the Menin Gate. For a brief few moments, the modern world is brought to a stop, and the last poo ceremony takes us back in time to the terrible years of the Great War as we pause to remember those that died. Myself, Leah Quayle, and Jody Wright were given the incredible honour of laying a wreath on behalf of Flirting Junior High School on Saturday the 18th of September during this special ceremony at Madden Gate.
It started out as a feeling which then grew into a hope, which then turned into a quiet thought, which then turned into a quiet word. And then that word grew louder and louder, till it was a battle cry. I'll come back when you call me, no need to say goodbye. Just because everything's changing doesn't mean it's never been this way. Just a feeling and no one knows yet, but just because they can't feel it too doesn't mean that you have to forget. Let your memories grow stronger and stronger till they're before.
Have a minute's silence to remember those who have fallen in the conflicts around the world.